Welcome to today's coffee break. Today we are discussing a new feature that became available in NAV 2018, and it's called employee ledgers or employee ledger entries. So let me just show you the employee card. So here I have a list of my employees, and we're going to go ahead and bring up Annette. And one of the fields that's on the employee card is on the payments fast tab. And that is the employee posting group. So this posting group points to, let me show you, the payables account. So I have set up in my general ledger, in my chart of accounts, I've got an employee's payable account. So let me show you where that comes into play. I'm going to go ahead and create a journal entry for this particular employee, and I'm just going to pretend that I'm putting in expenses. What that will do is I can actually post it to their account, and then I can go to the payment journal and suggest employee payments, and I can cut checks. What's nice about this is I often see vendor tables that are filled with employees because people want the ability to cut checks for the employees. So this separates that. Let me just show you where you see it. So in the journals, if I just go to my general journal, I've created a batch for my employee expenses. You don't have to, but I did, and I'm just going to open it up. And here's what it looks like. This is what's new. If you go to the account type, you used to have these GL account, customer, vendor, bank, fixed asset, IC partner, and now you have employee as an option. So you'll choose employee, and now you'll have the list of employees to select from. So we're selecting Annette. Now I can change the description to be something other than her name, something that's more meaningful. And there we go. And then I just choose my expense account for travel. There we go. And now I'm all set. So once you've entered all the different expenses in this general journal, selecting your account type as employee, you just post it like you normally would. There we go. And now if I go to my payment journal, I see this new button, which is a new process, which is suggest employee payments. I don't have to use this, just like I didn't have to use suggest vendor payments. I could go in here and do the same thing where I choose an account type, employee, and I type them in. But this is kind of a nice feature because it will go look at all the journal entries and see what's been paid and hasn't been paid on the employee, and it will bring it into the body of this screen. So I'm going to go to suggest employee payments, and I can choose if I want to summarize it or break it out line by line. These are the same types of options that you had in the suggest vendor payment screen. And I just want to put in my posting date, starting document number, which will be replaced by the check number. And I'm going to say that the money's coming out of this bank account and we are doing computer checks here. So I click OK. And now it has suggested that I create checks for Annette in the amount of $200 and John in the amount of $647. And if I look at the applies to, I will see that that is that entry that we just posted in the general journal for the expense. So once you cut the check, let's go back to the employees. You'll actually be able to go to the employee and go to their ledger entries, and you'll be able to see the expenses that you entered and the payments that were applied to those. And just like any other screen in Navision, you can go to the applied entries and you can see which transactions that payment was applied to. And you have the unapply option. So you can unapply things and reapply them just like you would in a normal ledger entry. And of course, I can drill down now and see the GL impact of this entry. If I navigate, I can look at my GL entry, show related entries, and I see here my expense account for travel, and we're back to that employee's payable account that we set up on the employee card. So I just want to show you some new functionality. It's always exciting to get with the new releases, so I wanted to share that with you. I hope you enjoyed today's coffee break.
Thanks for watching this Archer Point video. If you found it helpful, make sure to check out our website and blog at www.archerpoint.com. Additionally, if you have any questions regarding our products, services, or information in this video, feel free to email us at info@archerpoint.com. Thanks.